We're down here at the Red Light Galleries in beautiful downtown Akron, Ohio.
Hi.
We are talking here with Red Light Gallery artist Ron White. So, Ron, tell us a little bit about the art that you create.
I'm a two-dimensional and three-dimensional artist. I like different mediums. My favorite is ice. You're not going to see any of it here. Although for the Winterfest, I don't know if this will be dated, but tomorrow I'm going to be doing an ice carving for that event. Some of the sculpture that I do is here, figure artwork. There's some next door. And I do very large-scale drawings as well, and small pen and inks. But of the drawings, my favorite is the large compressed charcoal drawings.
Okay, and we're seeing quite a few of the large drawings that you're talking about here. Let me get out of the way. Here's an example of some of Ron's work. What is the title of this piece here, Ron? Okay. Excuse me. I was waiting for you to finish. I thought you were thinking about it. I do that so often when somebody asks me the title. So how did you get into doing the sculptures and the drawings?
Whenever I was in grad school, I was told that you can't put drawing and sculpture together. And I did a dual master's degree. But they only let me have one master's degree and I had to pick one, so I picked a life-size figural sculpture. From that, I started to do sculpture that had drawings on it, or sculpture that had scratch marks in it, which led me, to these pieces, which are reminiscent of that kind of thing, except for it's just a flat tile. But originally what it would be a huge figural sculpture that would have a color on it, and then I would scratch the tone into it. On my website, you can see one of the sculptures that are like that. I teach yoga too, and it's a sun pose where a person balances on their throat. And it's from a dreamscape, so the piece is reflective of the 50s where women took a pill for pregnancy, and their children ended up with flippers. So then what I did in this dreamscape is I attached chains from the flippers down to the top of the head. So when the sculpture's made, a small figure dangles from the chain that dangles from the flipper, and as you walk by, the finger makes marks in the top of the head, and all the tones that are on it are scratched into the surface.
Okay, well, that sounds pretty intense. And what was the name of your website?
RonWhiteArt.com.
Okay, RonWhiteArt.com. Okay, and you were talking about a couple pieces in the room next door. Why don't we go take a look at some of those?
Excellent. For some of the pieces like these ones, I like to show some kind of social setting. The bottom one's called Social Politics. There's a politician that's telling a joke, and the people that are around him are of different age groups reacting to his sense of humor or lack thereof. And then the middle one is from me being an altar boy at a young age. And the older women in the front row would always judge the young women walking through with whatever their clothing or choice of social, expression was of that time. So she's being ridiculed. And then the ladies at the top are more of the sculpture form I was talking about earlier, where they are these slab-built kind of form structures, and then all the tonal development on the surface is graffitoed or scratched into the surface.
So, as I was saying, there's some very intense work here. If we can get a close-up on this head back here, you can see what I'm saying. Just the intensity of that piece is really something.
That one's called The Scream. I'm working on a series of busts to produce imagery that people can see that I have enough talent to do portraiture. But the series is going to be evocative of emotions that are more than one emotion. So yes, he could be frightened, he could be angry in some extreme sense. The piece that was in the other room is more evocative of an emotion like concern and confusion and anguish, but you're not quite sure which one. So I'm trying to get him to slowly decline, and I have a third one to do, and I'm not quite sure where that's going to go quite yet.
Okay, so that's Ron. Ron White. You can see Ron down at Red Light Galleries at 111 North Main Street in Akron, Ohio. If you're not in the area, you can always check out his website at ronwhiteart.com. Thanks for joining us. Thank you, Ron.
Thank you.
Start spreading the news.
Whoa. You are just right on. Man. Okay, hold on. Right.
So what's going on?
So that was a really nice interview with Ron. Thanks for introducing us to Ron J.
Yes, you're welcome.
I like his work. I think it's a really interesting collection of style. I mean, it's the same style throughout, but he applies it to so many different mediums.
Right.
So it's really neat to see him. And if you want to see more of Ron White at ronwhiteart.com, you can come down and meet him personally here at the Red Light Galleries at 111 North Main Street.
Right. And now, he is not the comedian either.
No.
He's Akron's own artist, not the blue-collar comedian.
Exactly.
You're not going to see him with Jeff Foxworthy.
It's not the Ron White Comedy Tour. It's the Ron White Amazing Art Experience.
That is right.
So that's Ron White, and this has been another episode of
Artist Reality.
Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you soon.